So we clean house with the family, asking each morning in meditation that our Creator show us the way of patience, tolerance, kindliness, and love. The spiritual life is not a theory. We have to live it. God will constantly disclose more to you and to us. Ask Him in your morning meditation what you can do each day for the man who is still sick. The answers will come if your own house is in order. But obviously, you cannot transmit something you haven't got. See to it that your relationship with Him is right, and great events will come to pass for you and countless others. This is the great fact for us. Abandon yourself to God as you understand God. Admit your faults to Him and to your fellows. Clear away the wreckage of your past. Give freely of what you find and join us. We shall be with you in the fellowship of the Spirit, and you will surely meet some of us as you trudge the road of happy destiny. May God bless you and keep you. Until then. If circumstances warrant, we ask our wives or friends to join us in morning meditation. If we belong to a religious denomination which requires a definite morning devotion, we attend to that also. If not members of religious bodies, we sometimes select and memorize a few set prayers which emphasize the principles we have been discussing. There are many helpful books also. Suggestions about these may be obtained from one's priest, minister, or rabbi. Be quick to see where religious people are right. Make use of what they offer. As we go through the day, we pause, when agitated or doubtful, and ask for the right thought or action. We constantly remind ourselves we are no longer running the show, humbly saying to ourselves many times each day, "Thy will be done." We are then in much less danger of excitement, fear, anger, worry, self-pity, or foolish decisions. We become much more efficient. We do not tire so easily, for we are not burning up energy foolishly as we did when we were trying to arrange life to suit ourselves. It works. It really does. We alcoholics are undisciplined, so we let God discipline us in the simple way we have just outlined. But this is not all. There is action and more action. Faith without works is dead. On awakening, let us think about the 24 hours ahead. We consider our plans for the day. Before we begin, we ask God to direct our thinking, especially asking that it be divorced from self-pity, dishonest, or self-seeking motives. Under these conditions, we can employ our mental faculties with assurance, for after all, God gave us brains to use. Our thought life will be placed on a much higher plane when our thinking is cleared of wrong motives. In thinking about our day, we may face indecision. We may not be able to determine which course to take. Here we ask God for inspiration, an intuitive thought, or a decision. We relax and take it easy. We don't struggle. We are often surprised how the right answers come after we have tried this for a while. What used to be the hunch or the occasional inspiration gradually becomes a working part of the mind. Being still inexperienced and having just made conscious contact with God, it is not probable that we are going to be inspired at all times. We might pay for this presumption in all sorts of absurd actions and ideas. Nevertheless, we find that our thinking will, as time passes, be more and more on the plane of inspiration. We come to rely upon it. We usually conclude the period of meditation with a prayer that we be shown all through the day what our next step is to be, that we be given whatever we need to take care of such problems. We ask especially for freedom from self-will, and are careful to make no request for ourselves only. We may ask for ourselves, however, if others will be helped. We are careful never to pray for our own selfish ends. Many of us have wasted a lot of time doing that, and it doesn't work. You can easily see why.
Ten meditations for today. 1. I will be happy. I will have no expectations nor will I make demands today. I will give up my need to know anything or understand anything. Instead, I shall pause and seek the will and guidance of God, which will come intuitively, if I just become still and quiet. 2. I will adjust myself to what is, and not try to adjust everything to my own desires. I will take my luck as it comes, and fit myself to the stream of life. 3. I will try to live through this day only and not tackle my whole life problem at once. I can do something for 12 hours that would appall me if I felt that I had to keep it up for a lifetime. Four. I will be agreeable. I will look as well as I can, dress becomingly, talk low, act courteously, criticize, not one bit, not find fault with anything and not try to improve or regulate anybody except myself. 5. It is none of my business what anyone thinks about me or about anything else, and I don't have the power to make anyone change. That's God's job. 6. I will remember that it is not the experience of today that drives man mad. It is remorse or bitterness for something which happened yesterday and the dread of what tomorrow may bring. I will remember that the past is gone, it's just an image in my mind. I also have no stake in the future, for it is as yet unborn. Therefore, the present moment is the only real moment, and it is only in the present moment that a conscious contact with God can be found. 7. I will cease fighting anything or anyone, even alcohol, because what I resist persists. 8. I will be unafraid. Especially I will not be afraid to enjoy what is beautiful. I will remember that I am a spiritual mirror, and I will choose to believe that as I give love to the world, so the world will reflect love back to me. 9. I will have a quiet half hour all by myself, and relax. During this half hour, I will try to get a better perspective of my life. My goal is a sane peace of mind through spiritual living. 10. I will exercise my soul in 3 ways. I will do someone a good turn, and not get found out. If anybody knows of it, it will not count. I will do at least 2 things I don't want to do just for exercise.
The guidance I receive in meditation that is selfish, dishonest, resentful, or fearful is clearly guidance that came from me. Guidance that I receive in meditation, which is unselfish, honest, pure, and loving, I can be assured came from God. guidance I receive in meditation that is selfish, dishonest, resentful, or fearful is clearly guidance that came from me. Guidance that I receive in meditation, which is unselfish, honest, pure, and loving, I can be assured came from God.
Good morning, everybody. Good morning, everybody.
The guidance I receive in meditation that is selfish, dishonest, resentful, or fearful is clearly guidance that came from me. Guidance that I receive in meditation, which is unselfish, honest, pure, and loving, I can be assured came from God. guidance I receive in meditation that is selfish, dishonest, resentful, or fearful is clearly guidance that came from me. Guidance that I receive in meditation, which is unselfish, honest, pure, and loving, I can be assured came from God.